Hello, and welcome to this video demonstrating the complete functionality for the bulk deletion of student data in Sims. In the summer and autumn of 2018 releases of Sims, we introduced the first part of being able to bulk delete student data by different data domains. This video is going to review all the functionality available once upgraded to the spring 2019 release of Sims. To start with, let's review the ability to protect a student from the bulk delete process. We'll set this flag for a leaver who will be picked up in the bulk delete process, but this can also be set for students on roll and allocated in bulk update routines for students. Schools may have different reasons for setting this flag for a student, but we will by default not automatically set for any student who has been sent or ever in care. So onto the bulk delete process. Let's select Routines, Student, Bulk Delete Student Data. To help explain how the screen works, we're going to walk you through deleting a selection of students' conduct information. Firstly, we need to set the academic year in which students left or before. In this example, in this training data, we set this to 2013-2014, and we're going to choose the conduct data domain. Notice when you hover on a domain, you're informed of the data is going to delete. Once you're happy with the options, click on Search. So by default, the process will tick everyone except those who were ever SEN or ever in care. An improvement in the spring 2019 release of this functionality is that any student who only ever had an SEN status of N or marked as gifted or talented are no longer tagged as ever sent in this screen. Those students who have protected from bulk delete flags set are easily identified and not available to select for deletion. The user can choose to tick SEN or in-care students if they wish, but notice that the tick option is not available for Ben Abbott, who we protected in an earlier setup. The grid has a lot of functionality. You can sort columns. In this example, we will click on the column header for current age and reorder by that column. You can also filter by data in the columns. Here, we can filter the grid to only show those students who don't have SEN status, and then you're able to make your choices. Clicking on the search again will refresh the grid. It is possible to select all the students in the grid with the exception of those flagged as protected. In this example, we have selected all possible students. Once you're happy with the selection, you can click on Start Delete. The user will now be presented with a warning screen allowing them to review the data domains they are about to delete, how many students will be deleted, and details of any SEN or in-care students chosen. Clicking on OK will take the user to the confirmation window. This time, the user is asked to read the advisory notes and tick the agreement statement. Clicking on Continue will now start the delete process. The routine will now start deleting data for the first student and for the data domains chosen, and then move to the next student. So if we'd picked conduct and attendance, then for each student in turn, it would delete both sets of data before moving to the next student. While the delete process is running, the user can navigate to other areas of Sims and continue to work as normal. If required, the user can stop the delete process. The routine will complete the delete for the student it was working on and then stop. You are presented with the details of what was completed and then return to the bulk delete grid. If we search for the students again, you will see that the original number has gone down. The spring 2019 release of Sims includes the options to delete all student data. Clicking on the delete all student data will select all the data domains for you. This process will obviously take a lot longer to run, so users are advised to pick an appropriate time to complete this task. Lastly, I would like to explain what happens when you delete all the student data. The following diagram will help explain how Sims records person data and its relationship with deleting it. At the center of our Sims 7 database architecture and design is a single Sims person record. This is where core information such as forename and surname are stored. A Sims person can have many roles. A single person can have a role as an applicant, candidate, and a student. In another scenario, a student could also be recorded as a contact for another student, more likely in secondary schools than in primary, but it does happen. So when we run the delete all student data routine, We will attempt to delete all the student data and the central person record, but only where that SIMS person record is linked to prospective pupil, student, user, candidate, and application roles. If the same SIMS person record is linked to any of the blue roles, i.e. is also an employee, we will delete the student-related data in green, but retain the central SIMS person record as it forms part of the contact record. I hope this video has helped demonstrate the bulk delete student data feature in SIMS. Thank you for watching.